First time in America, it's first time in New York, first time in a North American Comic Con, which is like a whole thing. Can we make a lot of noise and please welcome to the stage, Masashi Kishimoto. It's a good job, guys. Joining Kishimoto-sensei on the far left is Mr. Otsuki. He's actually the final editor of Naruto, and Mr. Kishimoto's editor. All right, so very, very first thing I want to say on behalf of myself and everyone in the room, congratulations for completing the manga of Naruto.
Chris, I think he wants to say a brief greeting to the fans.
Oh, that'd be wonderful. Please go ahead.
Nice to meet you. My name is Masashi Kishimoto. 今日はよろしくお願いします。
My name is Masashi Kishimoto. I am really, really, really pleased to meet you today.
Did you ever imagine that Naruto would go on for as long as it did? 72 volumes. It's an incredible accomplishment.
Actually, you know, I never imagined it. In fact, I actually thought it might get canned after the 10th week. That's actually a regular occurrence at Jump, that if the fan reaction is not very good, episode 10, the end.
Well, luckily we all got 72 volumes of Naruto. I gotta ask, actually, it's 72 volumes of Naruto. Did the editors of Shonen Jump want you to keep going? I mean, some of the Shonen Jump series go for 100 volumes or 200 volumes. Did the editors want you to keep going on Naruto?
しかし 72巻って言っても ある 連載は 100巻 または 200巻も 続く 連載も ありますので もしくは 編集の方から いや もっと 長く 続け と 言われたり されました
それは 上の 上層部の 方から 圧力は ありましたけど 僕は なるべく 自分で ここまで っていう とこは 決めて やりました
Well, I would be lying if I said that there wasn't some pressure from the very upper management, the powers that be, as they were. But, you know, I had a pretty clear idea of how I wanted the story to come to a close, and I kind of put my foot down and said, no, I'm sorry, this is it.
Mm. Now, I actually went back and found your very first English language interview in 2006 for Shonen Jump USA, and you said that you had the ending of Naruto perfectly visualized, the layout, the text, the scenes, and that was in 2006, this is almost 10 years later. Were you able to execute the ending exactly like you imagined it would be?
僕は実は先生の最初に英語、英訳された マダラの手が組むところはもう最初に絵で描いてありました。それをずっとノートに書いてて、しまってました。お願いします。Actually,
it really was all in my head. I actually had envisioned that Naruto and Sasuke would make the sign of reconciliation. in the Valley of Endings by the statues of First Hokage, Hashirama, and Madara. That was, I actually had visualized all that.
Oh, that's so cool that you had that finished from the very beginning, and then you actually were able to manage to put it in at the very end, too. That's very, very cool. I know you've been working on some of the stuff like this Seventh Seal, or the Scarlet Hokage and the Seventh Seal. It's very nerve-wracking to be in front of you guys. You guys love Naruto so much. straight up, you've been working on a lot of stuff. The Boruto movie, the new manga, the side stories, the novels. It seems like, though, that you might be just winding down a little bit and taking a little bit better care of yourself. Is that true? Or is your workload still, you know, every day like it was with the weekly Shonen Jump?
その時は休めてなかった。最近です、本当に。最近休めるようになりました。 子供と遊んでます。
So, yeah, I would say that life got a little bit easier when I finished drawing the series. On the other hand, I mean, it might not be obvious to the fans who don't know the timeline, but literally, as I was drawing the last chapter, I was told that I would be working on the screenplay for the new movie, Boruto. And it was the first time I actually managed to work on an entire screenplay by myself. Mm. But on the other hand, that came right after the series. So, you know, it's only very recently that I was truly able to start relaxing just a teeny bit and spending more time with my children. Mm. It was only after I finished the screenplay and the actual production on the movie started that I was able to start taking a break.
So I actually heard you got married while you were doing Naruto, is that correct? Like you got married after you were sort of already drawing?
なんか連載中にご結婚なされたと聞いたんですけど、嘘ですか本当ですか?
本当です。
It's the truth.
But I heard you were actually so busy with Naruto, you were actually never able to go on honeymoon. Is that true?
で、さらになんか連載で忙しかったため、新婚旅行にも行かれなかったと聞いたんですけど。本当です。That is also the truth.
So, I mean, this is your first trip to America. This is a honeymoon with all of your fans in America. How's that?
じゃあこのアメリカに来ることニューヨークに来ること自身が新婚旅行ではないのでしょうか。皆さんのファンと一緒の新婚旅行。あの、なんでしょう。それはね、子供に学校がありまして、連れて来られなかったので、奥さんも子供と一緒にいるので残念ながら今回はダメだったんで、今度また来たいと思います。家族揃って。はい。お願いします。You
know, I would love to have said so, and nothing against you guys, but unfortunately, there's something called school, and my children I have to go to school, and therefore my wife had to stay behind in Japan as well. So, much as I love you all, it's not really a full-out honeymoon. So, that just means I have to come back to America someday.
Now, in every good shonen story, there's the hero, but there's also the rival who pushes the hero to achieve great things. In manga production, it's very clear that your rival is Oda-sensei, creator of One Piece. Now, your series started within a few years of each other. You've battled it out as the most popular manga in Shonen Jump. How does Oda-sensei feel now that his rival has stopped making his rival manga series? Has he said anything to you about it?
まあ、もちろん、ナルトだけでもなく、よく少年漫画にはヒーローがあり、ヒーローのライバルがあるんですけど、漫画だけでもなく、実際に、先生に対してライバルは、その小田先生と聞いてるんですけど、このナルトが完結されて、ライバルをなくして、なんか小田先生からのコメントとかリアクションとかありましたでしょうか？
はい。 僕にとって、まあ、ライバルはワンピースの尾田栄一郎先生なんですけど、で僕も勝手に言ってたんですけど、向こうも意外とライバルとして最後のコメントで認めてくれたっていうか、ライバルでためともっていうふうに最後のナルトの回で裏のコメントで書いてくれたので、とても嬉しかったのと、あとワンピースもナルトもずっと長い間やってるんで、いつ終わんのみたいなのは言われるんですけど、で2人で会った時にいつこの漫画俺ら終わるんだろうねっていう話はしてて、それでワンピースがその、まあ、なかなか終わらないので、ナルトが終わったのを見て、あ、自分の漫画もいつか終わるんだっていうことに気づいたって言ってました。だから終われるっていうことを実感したって言ってました。お願いします。
So yes, indeed, I would say my rival is One Piece's creator, Eiichiro Oda. And honestly, it's interesting because I was just saying that on my own in the beginning, and then finally, in the back of volume 72, Oda-sensei acknowledged the fact that he considers me his rival as well, and that felt so gratifying. And of course, both One Piece and Naruto ran together for so long and ran even in Japan in Shonen Jump together, that sometimes we'd meet up and be like, oh, you know, I wonder how long our mangas are going to go on. And then, you know, of course, One Piece kept going and going. And so when I finally, you know, said, well, actually, Naruto is going to be concluding soon, it kind of gave him the awareness that, oh, I guess One Piece may have to, or may conclude sometime in the future too. It gave him awareness of an ending.
Oh. And I want to stress, Naruto has been an incredible success story in North America, in Japan, around the world. It's actually throughout its career not just been the best-selling manga, which it has been. It's not just been some of the best-selling comics. It's actually the best-selling comic series. It's actually been one of the best-selling books of all time on several weeks of release for the Naruto manga, outselling every other kind of fiction, nonfiction, everything. Naruto is a genuine phenomenon. And I guess, when did you first realize? Well, yeah, we can apply for that.
まあ、ナルトの大成功は、まあ、特に北米ではその漫画のジャンルだけでなく、あのコミックス全体の分野だけでもなく、もう本当本出版されてる本、あの書籍全体的にベストセラーでもあったんですよ。それについて、あの先生はいつ気づき、どういうご感想か教えていただけますか。
今知りました。びっくりです。
I actually just found that out. about the it being a top selling book, not just a comic or a manga. どう思われますか。
もう信じられない。嬉しいです。
I'm really happy, but I'm still having trouble processing it.
Well, when did you first realize the effect that Naruto is having on fans around the world? Like, it's so popular, and it changed so many people's lives.
いつじゃあそのまあ日本のファンだけでなく世界中にもファンがいらっしゃって、世界中のファンにナルトが影響を与えてるって知ったのはいつ頃ですか？
初代担当の矢作さんという方がいるんですが、一緒に立ち上げた担当さんがいて、その担当さんがからあのファンレターを来た、あの週刊少年ジャンプに届くファンレターがあるんですけど、それをいただいた時になんかあのいっぱいこう読めない、僕日本語しかできないんで読めない、あのいろんな国のファンレターが届くようになって、あれこれもしかしてっていうふうに思ったのが最初です。
So actually I guess I might haveKind of started realizing it when my first editor, Mr. Yahagi-san, we have, you know, the Shueisha office, and there's a specific department for Weekly Shonen Jump, and fan letters would be sent there. And he came by and would give me a bundle of letters every time he'd see me, and I started noticing that there were letters that I couldn't read, I'm Japanese and I only know Japanese. So any other language would look like, well, Greek to me. So, you know, and that's when I guess started realizing that, wow, there are fans that don't live just in Japan.
That's super cool. Do you ever feel like anything has surprised you about the fan reaction from international fans to Naruto?
ではその海外のファンへ、あの、ナルトへの反応にびっくりされたこととかありますか？
そうですね。その、とにかくその、最近にこう iPad とかで、あの、いろんな映像が見れるようになって、そのコスプレの方とか、あの、を目にするようになって、それでちょっとびっくりしました。はい。あと、自分でその、さっき言ったあの、ファンレターを、あの、どうにか解読しようと思ったんですけど、あの、全然できなくて、いいファンレターだと勝手に自分で思い込んでるんですけど、あの、何でしょう。とにかくそういうも、あの、手紙とか、あとコスプレの方とか、そういう映像とか、その文字の媒体とかで見て、あの、実感しましたね。はい。
I would say I think I really started becoming more aware of it. I don't know about surprise, but definitely, you know, it's really sinking in when more recently with the iPad, I've been able to look at images or watch videos of cosplayers from all over the world. And that made me realize, you know, how much passion, not just how much you love Naruto, but how much passion you can express with my work. And in fact, there was one time that I was thinking about trying to make heads or tails of all the foreign fan letters I received, and you know, I kind of gave up on that. But I wanted to think that they were all positive. But you know, especially seeing all the images of all the cosplayers out there made me truly realize what a global impact the work has had.
あともう一つ、もうまさに今がそれです。今皆さんを見てそう思いました。今です。今、
and actually, that's something that just came to me as I look out upon all of you.
Cosplay has always been such a big part of the Naruto phenomenon. Everyone's got headbands on today. Everyone, hands up and scream if you got a headband on.
舞台当てをつけてる方の手を挙げてくださいって言って、
手を挙げます。And I love the character designs in Naruto. They're so good, and they're always fresh, and you keep redesigning the characters as they get older as well. Did you ever think about the cosplayability of the character designs? Because people love to play cosplay Naruto more than maybe any other series. And did you think about that when you were designing it, that people would be wearing the character designs that you had created?
まあ僕はいつもあの、Naruto を読んで、Naruto のキャラクターデザインがすごく優れてると思ってたんですけど、あの、もちろんその、あの、Naruto の人気が、あの、人気になってから、その、本当にアメリカ、まあ、あの、海外のコスプレイヤーもすごく増えたんですね。特に Naruto のコスプレイヤーが増えたんですけど、先生はもともとからその、まあ、コスプレしやすいキャラクターデザインとか認識しながら、意識しながら描いたんですか？
いや、それはね、全く考えてなかったです。なので、あの、コスプレしにくいのもいっぱいあると思うんですけど、もう皆さん、だからコスプレイヤーの方はすごく大変だなってちょっと反省してます。特にこことか皆さん蒸れてませんか？大丈夫ですか？蒸れてませんか？って、お願いします。
Actually, not at all. In fact, I actually feel like a lot of my characters might not be so easy to cosplay. And in fact, you know, to all of you out there who raised your hand saying you had headbands on, I feel really bad and I kind of feel remorse because, I mean, are you sure you don't have like a rash that it's not rubbing, like kind of rubbing against it and chafing at all?
You guys are all right though with the headband?
Oh,
they're okay. I know, now I want to actually talk about a little bit more about the manga. I know you greatly admire the work of mangaka Katsuhiro Otomo, creator of Akira, which is awesome, by the way, and Domu, and Akira Toriyama, creator of Dragon Ball. Yeah, it's a Shonen Jump audience, love it. But I wonder if there's any other manga you're fond of. I know you really, I've heard about maybe Sonora Sensei or Matsumoto Sensei. Any mangaka that you really like? Manga that you really like?
で、あの、まあ、あの、昨日でもそうですし、以前にも、あの、聞いたのは、まあ、大友先生のアキラ。 それから、まあ、鳥山先生のドラゴンボールとかに強く影響されてお好きだと聞いたんですけど、他の漫画家、例えば、まあ、あの松本太陽なり、あの先生なり、佐村先生なり以外の漫画家、または漫画作品がお好き、または影響されたものってありますか？
はい、手塚治虫先生の火の鳥の方編とかですね、あと、井上雄彦先生のスラムダンクとか、あと、あの浦沢直樹先生のモンスターとか20世紀少年、そういうのが好きです。影響を受けました。
I have to say that I've also over the years enjoyed and also perhaps influenced by Osamu Tezuka Sensei's Phoenix, especially the Karma arc. And then I would say Takahiko Inoue's Slam Dunk. And finally, I mean, there's so many, but if I had to narrow it down, another person I would mention is Naoki Urasawa's Monster, as well as the 20th Century Boys.
Ah, all very good series. one of my favorite parts of the manga is, especially in the early volumes, the notes you would do to reader. To the readers about sort of your life and about breaking into the manga industry. I think a lot of people found them very inspirational, that you really worked and tried and finally sort of made it in. And I actually, you know, I want to... The thing is, though, I mean, you tried a lot of different manga and a lot of different age groups and things like that, but ultimately I felt like maybe Jump was the most important to you. Was it really important to make a Jump manga, to be a Jump mangaka?
でまあ、あのナルト の,、まあ、あの単行本で最初あの1話1話の間にあの作者コメントの欄がありますけど、そこでよくなんかいろいろ書いてらして、まあ、本当に先生の熱心、あの漫画制作に関しての熱心とか感じたんですけど、はい、そのあのナルトより前も以前もなんかいろんなジャンルとかいろんなテーマの漫画にあの挑戦されたとか聞いてるんですけど、あの先生にやっぱり一番やっぱりあの念願に思ってたのがジャンプだったんですか？
そうです、ジャンプだけです。あの僕がジャンプ黄金期、あのドラゴンボール、北斗の拳、セイントセイヤ、そのあたりを読んであの育ったので、あのリアルタイムでずっとジャンプを読んで育ったので、あのもう憧れはもうそこにしかなくて、もうジャンプ以外は考えられなかったです。
Yeah, I have to say that no matter what projects, what stories I came up with in the end, my dream was always to be part of or succeed in Shonen Jump. And I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that when I grew up, I was reading Shonen Jump, weekly Shonen Jump during its golden age. And this includes series like Dragon Ball, Fist of the North Star, Saint Seiya. I read these in real time, week by week, when I was growing up. And I think that's why, you know, it was always kind of like this, you know, sometimes far off, but always a goal that I wanted to achieve.
Thank you. Now, that era of Jump that you're talking about is largely considered to be the sort of golden age, the golden era of Jump. I read an interview between you and Oda-sensei where you both said you were both lucky to have read Jump during that time. But, I mean, for fans today, especially in North America, that manga wasn't available. And so when Shonen Jump started here in North America, a little bit less than 15 years ago, it included Dragon Ball for the first time, serialized, Dragon Ball Z. It included yourself, it included Oda's Sensei's One Piece, it included Kuro Sensei's Bleach. Lots of long-running series that changed the face of comics, of manga in North America. And I guess I think that maybe that era of Jump, your era of Jump, could be considered a new golden age. What do you think? What do you guys think?
まあ以前小田先生との対談でも、あの小田先生もそうおっしゃってたんですね。やっぱりその黄金の時代に、あの彼もジャンプを読んで育ったって。だけど残念ながらアメリカではまだそういうあの作品とかがまだ渡ってきてなかった時代なんです。で、そのアメリカでの英語版の少年ジャンプ、まあ月刊だったんですけど、リリースされた時、まあまだ15年も行ってないんですけど、もちろん先生のナルト以外にもドラゴンボール、ワンピース、ブリーチとか、あの全部あの連載で初めてアメリカで、はい、 まあ、現れたんですけど、僕多分ファンにとってはその時代、まあ、2003年あたりからがアメリカのジャンプの黄金の時代と思われたと思いますけど、先生はどう思われますか？
それだったらちょっとおこがましいんですけど、先輩方の前では言えないんですけど、ここには先輩方いないので今が黄金期だと思います。
You know, it rings very, very happily, reverberates really happily within me, even though I'm kind of embarrassed because I'd feel ashamed to say this in front of my mentors, the people that I consider the gods that came before me. Then again, they're not here, so maybe I can say it. But yeah, maybe it would be great to call it that the golden age here for Jump.
Now, as a special treat for everybody, Kishimoto-sensei has agreed to maybe draw for us, and we're going to show it up on the screens. Do you guys want to see Kishimoto-sensei draw? Is that what you want? Are you ready to do that? Ah, all right, so. So, what are you going to draw for us today?
I'm going to do my best. Sensei, 何を描きますか?
Guys, calm down.
I kind of thought about other things, but I guess I'd at least have to start with Naruto. All right.
Now, while Kishimoto-sensei is drawing here, I'm going to put Otsuki-sensei on the spot because he has to answer some questions now. Otsuki-sensei, what do you think makes a hit manga? Because Naruto is a hit, right, everybody? There you go.
ヒット作品の秘密、方式を教えていただけますか？
キャラクターが魅力的であることかなと、まあ、どんな作品がヒットするか分かれば、まあ、僕らいらないというか、僕らもの仕事もだいぶ楽なんですけれど、まあ、とにかくキャラクターが魅力的であることかなと思います。
Well, I guess, you know, certainly an important thing is to have very appealing and attractive characters. But if we really knew the secrets of making hit manga, you wouldn't need us. And, you know, I might not have a job. It might not necessarily be a bad thing that we don't truly know. In fact, if anyone of you know, please let us know.
this is for both of you guys. In the last chapter of Naruto, we fast forward to 15 years later. Naruto is a dad now. He's got a son, Boto, and he, you know, he's going to go on adventures. We're going to talk a little bit about that. There's maybe a movie screening tomorrow. You're Saturday morning. You guys are all going to the movie screening, right? But the thing about the movie is, I mean, we saw the trailer, and it's crazy. Like, there's skyscrapers in Naruto now, and like computers and stuff like that. And one of the things that I thought about the series is that because it ended on such a peaceful note, it ended on the sort of end of fighting, was that is all that stuff that happened, that great technological advancement, because we've had peace for so many years. Do you think peace brings about prosperity in that way?
Well, I'm talking about this, but 一応その最終話第700話で、まあ結構未来へタイムスリップして、まあ、ナルトがお父さんになり息子がいて、で突然なんか背景に高層ビルとか、 なんかコンピューターとか、 なんかいろいろなんか以前なんか世界に存在しなかったものが突然現れたんですけど、それってやっぱり平和な世界になったからでしょうか？
まあそうです
そうです
Yes, indeed.
Oh, very good. Thank you. I'm actually curious because you came in towards the end of Naruto as the editor on the project. Was it intimidating to take over such a beloved series as editor?
まあ Otsuki さんは、はい、Naruto 途中からそれも後半、
はい、
もうほとんど完結近い時点で ナルトのお仕事を始めたと聞いてるんですけど、ちょっとなんかやっぱり恐れを感じたというか、はい、まあ、こんなに人気な作品でファンがこれだけ大好きな作品に関わるになんか怖かったっていうことはありましたか？
最初にその担当票っていうのをいただくんですけれど、間違ってると思いましたね、やっぱり。嘘だって思いました。でもまあよく見ると本当だったので、まあ、とてもびっくりしました。
I have to say that when, you know, we actually have at Shonen Jump at Shueisha a list of what series will be edited by which editors. And when I first saw the list with my name on it, I couldn't believe it. I thought it was either a typo or maybe like an April Fool's joke. And then, you know, I looked at it again. I was like, that's actually my name. And it's actually on the same line as Naruto.
僕も小学生の頃から見てた作品だったので。
Especially since this was a title that I had seen. That I had watched and read as a kid too.
That's awesome. Thank you so much. I don't want to pressure you. Do you want to do one more?
プレッシャーはかけたくないんですけど、もう一枚書いていただけますか？
All right, everyone scream their favorite character at the top of their lungs. I think I heard... Wait. Okay. Calm down. Actually, other than Naruto, who's your favorite character in this series?
だけど先生自身はナルト以外でしたら誰が次にお好きですか？
そうですね。なるべく簡単に描けるやつがいいんですけど、なんだろう。マダラ？マダラ。
あ、多分トビとして面を
描
ける。ジライヤ。ジライヤ。
じゃあジライヤ描きます。
Then why not go with Jiraiya?
All right, Otsuki-sensei, and Naruto has a very, very unique take on shonen manga. In that series, even the worst character, no matter how bad they are, how evil they are, they get redeemed in some way. They're sympathetic, they're understandable. And in some shonen manga, some characters are just like bad to the bone and then they die. But everyone in Naruto gets redeemed in some way. I'm really curious about where that comes from. I mean, what you think about that?
Naruto は shonen manga としても結構ユニークなのは、悪役でさえも結局、まあ、反省してやり直しするキャラクター、いいキャラ、まあ、そのまま役で残っててもなんかちょっといいとこが出てくるキャラクターとか多いんですけど、それってどこからそういうなんかアイデアとかが来たんですか？
悪役のキャラクター造形として、はい、僕は答えることなのかっていうのはちょっと微妙なところではあると思うんですけれど、やっぱりやっぱりそのキャラクターがそのお話の都合で動いているわけではなくて、やっぱりそれぞれ岸本先生がキャラクター一人一人の生い立ちであったり、まあ、彼はまあこういう生い立ちだからこういうでこうなってこういう考えに至ったということを全てしっかり考えられているからだと思います。まあ、そうするとやっぱり彼がこうなった、こういうことをするのにも絶対に理由があると、キャラクターそれぞれに、バックボーンをちゃんと持たせてキャラクターを作っておられるからだと思います。
I think the reason why it's different and where that comes from, of course, it's kind of weird for me to answer it because it all comes from him. And you know, I think it's because these characters aren't just influenced by the story or do whatever they do in the story because of the story, but because when each character first appears or even before that, Sensei has very carefully laid out how he wants the character to be, what his personality traits are, what has he done, what is he about to do, and a complete his personal history and background on each and every character, whether they be good characters or evil characters or villains. And so by understanding the character for who he is, to make the character he or she a complete, well-rounded character, I think is why they do become relatable. Because they're not just flat images on paper.
I think every, I mean, we've seen here from all the shouting, everyone's got their own favorite character in Naruto. There's so many different characters. And I feel like it's really easy to find somebody in the story that you really relate to. Otsuki-san, who do you relate to in the series?
Otsuki-san, what do you relate to the character most?
Sasuke.
I guess Sasuke.
Oh.
And you, Chris?
Rock Lee. He tries so hard. It's so inspiring. All right, so I gotta do a thing first, because I know the last volume's only been out for a week or two. Can I just get I was gonna say show of hands, but you guys can scream. Who hasn't read the last volume of Naruto? Because I don't want to spoil it if there's a lot of people.
72巻はまだ読んでない人手を挙げてください。あ、結構。
There are not enough of you. I am definitely going to spoil this. You guys ready? All right.
あ、ネタバレになって申し訳ないんですけど。
No, I'll be good. I'll be good. So Sasuke keeps winning the character pulls for most popular character in Naruto. And Naruto's the hero, right? And I always find it fascinating because Sasuke's got this pessimistic worldview. He thinks everything is going to fall apart unless he specifically holds it together. And Naruto's like, no, it's all going to work out. It's going to be great. And yet everyone's still like, no, Sasuke's got it. Sasuke knows what it's all about. I'm curious because I think that's a pessimistic worldview. And I think Naruto's worldview is very optimistic. What do you think? But like, is the in the end, Naruto maybe defeats Sasuke's worldview and brings Sasuke around. So, do you think ultimately that by liking Sasuke, you're more of a pessimistic person or a more optimistic person?
Well, もちろんあの Naruto の世界観は結構楽観主義であり、逆に Sasuke は結構悲観。
Oh, actually, I'm going to change it a little bit. I don't want him to think that say he's pessimistic. I'm going to say, do you think it's easier for everybody to relate to a pessimistic character? How about that? That way he's off the spot a little bit.
悲観主義なんですけど、まあ僕に関してもやっぱり明るい方がいいと思うんですけど、なぜかやっぱりその人気投票では Sasuke 一番人気である、もう繰り返し Sasuke の方がNarutoより一番になってるんですけど、それってやっぱり一般の人、ごく普通の人はやっぱりその悲観主義の方に共感しやすいからだと思いますか？
まあ単純にあいつがの見た目がサスケの見た目がかっこいいというのもあると思うんですけれど、そうですね、やっぱりそのでもキャラクターそれぞれ映し鏡というかいろんな考え方があるので、ただまあ悲しいより悲しいことはまあ世の中実際には多いと思うんですけれど、やっぱりフィクションの中ではまあ楽観主義なキャラクターが勝つというのはすごくいいことだと思います。
Well, I think some of it might just be even simpler than that, and the fact that Sasuke looks cooler and is kind of cooler,
yeah.
You know, even in terms of his abilities. But you know, whether it's Sasuke or Naruto, optimistic or pessimistic, and you know, there's everything in between as well.They're all reflections of some personality that exists out in the real world. And of course, you know, in fiction is not reality. And in reality, there's not always a happy ending. But because this is fiction, I guess that's why we end up focusing more or concentrating, highlighting more the optimistic worldview.
The jump worldview of you can do it.
Yeah.
That's a very thoughtful answer. Thank you very much, Otsuki-san. So we've got time for a couple more questions, and I'm just gonna do. Oh, sorry.
Do you want to answer a question?
Why don't you have an answer or something about the drawing? じゃあ先生、この2枚の色紙に描かれたジライアと、ジライア先生とナルトですけど、 あのなんか絵に関してなんかコメントとかありますか？
そうですね、ナルトはあの久しぶりに描いたんで、あの久しぶりによっていう感じ、久しぶりっていう感じでした。でジライアはあの正直あんま覚えてなくてネットで調べたんですけど、ここ繋がらないから、あそこにあのジライアのコスプレされてる方を参考にしました。
So actually, it's the first time in a while that I actually drew Naruto or any character from Naruto. So I did have a little bit of nostalgia, but also I have to embarrassingly admit, I don't quite remember how to draw Jiraiya. And I tried to look it up, but I couldn't connect to the Wi-Fi. So in fact, I used the Jiraiya cosplayer in the audience as my model.
Thank you.Thank you very much. 助かりました。
So thank you, Jiraiya cosplayer. You saved me one.
Now, as you all know, coming up this Saturday, it's the Boruto movie, Naruto the movie, at the Hammerstein Ballroom. When the original trailer was released for the Boruto movie, it had the line from you, "This is the pinnacle."Of my career is the Boruto movie. So I would love to hear from you why you think that this movie that we're all going to go see on Saturday is the absolute pinnacle of your career.
まああの土曜日に明後日にニューヨークでもあの上映されるんですけど、はい、このボルトの映画に関してインタビューではこのボルトがご自身のキャリアのあの頂点の作品だとおっしゃってたんですけど、それはなぜですか？
正直に言えばその脚本を全部僕が初めて書いたので、はっきり言えば僕が漫画で書きたかった部分なんですよね。そこをあのアニメにしてもらったっていうのがあるので、なので僕の中では本当に最後の最後のナルトの最後の物語と思っています。なのでそこが最後のクライマックスと思って、あのこれ以上は書けない対抗傑作って言いました。
So honestly, as I briefly mentioned before, this was the first time I'd actually been able to work on a screenplay from beginning to end. It's not the first Naruto screenplay I've done, but certainly the one that I personally wrote the entire screenplay. And, you know, the story is essentially something that I wanted to draw as a manga, but didn't have the opportunity to. So I was really able to make it... the story and the characters and everything what I wanted to see done and then have had the honor to have the anime come to life. But on the other hand, it's also something that I envision as this is the last chapter of Naruto. The last climax scene, etc.
Oh my goodness. Well,
そうなんです。
I think we should watch the trailer for Boruto. Do you guys want to watch the... Let's watch the trailer for Boruto. Tech people, we're doing it. We're watching the trailer for... How you doing? It's a good looking audience right here. All right.
嬉しい。嬉しいです。こんな喜んでいただいて。
I'm about to cry tears of joy too.
Kishimoto sensei, is there anything you'd like to say to the audience? Just one last remark.
あの皆さんファン、あの集まったファン、集まれなかったファンにも何か一言お願いできますか？
そうですね。ここまだまだこう会場に来れなかった方っていうのもいるっていうのも聞いてたんで、それほどこうなると僕がただその日本であの縁側で普通に落書きとして書いたナルトがここまであのみんなにあの認めてもらえるっていうか知ってもらえて喜んでもらえるっていうのは本当に感無量です。あの全てのファンの方にも 感謝っていうかありがとうの言葉しか伝えることはできません。お願いします。
So, you know, I heard that there are many fans that couldn't even make it today, and to hear that after seeing how many people are already here, you know, this is just a little title that I started working on so many years ago without ever thinking about any impact that it might have, much less globally. All I could say is to know how many of you, how many fans love my work and have followed my work. I'm just so grateful. The only thing I really can think of saying is thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Masashi Kishimoto sensei.
Thank you very much.
We'd like to thank Otsuki-san. We'd like to thank Mari, our translator. Go to the Viz booth, 1346, to get the last Naruto Blast Blu-ray, volume 72.